Welcome! Today's topic of our discussion will be the world of feelings. So let's get started!
What exactly is happiness? Is a new car or everyday perfect look? Or is it health or family? Well, we are going to answer the questions today.
Well, everyone needs to different to be happy. Now science says that they can actually measure to happiness simply by asking people how happy they are.
The leading American psychologist Professor Ellie Ward told that the science of happiness is based on the straightforward idea.
It may sound silly, but we just ask people how happy are you? 1 to 10. Of course the measures are not perfect. Yet I think they are in many ways as good as the measure that economists use.
Happiness is something everyone wants to have. But you may be successful and have a lot of money, but without family and love, it will be meaningless.
We asked Professor Ellie about definition of happiness.
I would say that happiness is a decision. Your happiness. It's your decision.
Happiness is the most beautiful of all feelings. Sciences claim that there are 4 types of happiness: euphoria, solicitude, excitement, and ecstasy.
We needed to experience and these feelings at least from time to time to be really happy. And now we give you some tips of happiness. At the bright side of life.
Think about solution, not about problems.
Each day devote some time to reading a few pages of an inspiring book or article.
Watch your thoughts whenever you catch yourself thinking negative thoughts. Start thinking of pleasant things.
Watch funny comedies that make you laugh.
What is it?
Listen to relaxing, uplifting music.
To accomplish several objectives. At the end of the day, you might feel frustrated and unhappy because you haven't been able to do all of those things. Sometimes you spend all day successful, carrying out many plans, but instead of feeling happy and satisfied, you look at what you not accomplished and feel unhappy. It's unfair toward yourself.
Each day, do something good for yourself. It can be something small, such as buying a book, eating something you love, watching your favorite program on TV, going to a movie, or just having a stroll on the beach.
Each day, do at least one act to make others happy.
This can be a kind word. Helping your friends, stopping your car at the crossroads to let people cross, giving your seat in a bus to someone else, or giving a small present to someone you love. The possibilities are infinite.
When you make someone happy, you become happy, and then people try to make you happy.
Always expect happiness.
Associate with happy people and try to learn from them to be happy. Remember, happiness is contagious.
Smile more often!
We give you an interview which tells you what people think about happiness.
Happiness is more than cupcakes, rainbows and puppies. I feel that happiness is letting off everything that makes you sad. You decide what comes and goes in your life. Whatever makes you smile makes your mind feel free.
Happiness is always there, you just don't really take the time to acknowledge it. When you was a kid, happiness at the time was all about having the coolest car or boyfriend and have everyone as your friend, and if you didn't have it, any of those, your life was miserable. years later, it took me time to realize that I have always had everything that I had needed and wanted in life to make me feel complete and happy. I'm still getting older and I can only wonder what is still waiting for me at the end of the tunnel.
I feel like overthinking, stress and anxiety can get in the way of happiness. Instead of your mind being at easy, your mind is running on the fast treadmill with multiple hurdles. These thoughts might disturb you mentally and emotionally. Only you can overcome these issues, and when you do, you will find your original happiness along with the happiness of dropping all the negative thoughts and emotions.
Depending on situations, happiness could be work. As previously said, happiness is always around. You know, you just have to discover it. You must overcome the pessimist emotions and anything else that gets in the way of happiness.
When you see a happy person, the people and things they love surround them. You can ask a family that doesn't have every luxury in the world if they are happy, and they probably say yes because they have each other and each other's company. For unhappy people, you can have all the money in the world, but if you're alone, you have no one to share it with. I feel like one of the core things that happiness is having people that you love and care about always around you.
As a social media junkie, I think that social media has changed our happiness for the better. You can keep in touch with people easily, laugh at videos and read hilarious tweets. Plus, you may meet your special someone through social media.
Growing up, my mom did talk about happiness. Since I grew up, as only child with a single mother, she proved to me that even one person can give you all the love and happiness.
The biggest challenge for me right now is finishing school and currently find my happiness. My ex and I recently broke up from 4 years. A relationship, and I'm slowly going through the healing process. On top of that, my mom is lately home because of work. Lately, I have been feeling lonely and sad because I'm not used to not having someone constantly being there. I know I have friends and other family members that are always there for me, but it's not the same feeling. I know over time I will conquer this feeling and find the happiness I previously had.
What will make me smile right now? I'm not even kidding you, a puppy. I know my own puppy will be there for me to make me happy. A puppy would be a constant company to me and will cuddle with me when I'm sad. I think that never trying is worse. Just like that popular saying, you never know unless you try. That release of food, sky driving, telling someone you like them, just anything.
Some things in life are bad, they can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, that grumble, give a whistle, and this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. Hey,
always look
It's quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene, give the audience a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow. So always look on the bright side of death. Just before you draw your terminal breath. Life's a piece of shit when you look at it. Life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show, keep 'em laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And always look on.